Morning. It's the 26th of January today. Freezing, cold, wet, windy. Must be mad for coming here. Eh? But it's got to be done. I have got a few things to do with the day, so I'll be cracking on with that. But first of all, like always, fire on, kettle on. I've got some bacon. I'll have a bacon sandwich. And the gardening program starts again today, so I'll have a listen to that while I'm having a cuppa. And I'll catch you in a bit.
It's Dave at the allotment.
Whoa, not very nice out there. I've had my bacon, the kettle's boiled there, fire's on. But I did say I did have something to do today, and I'll just quickly show you what it is. Now, I know I keep going on about skip finds. Well, you've got to look in skips because you never know what you find, and I'll just quickly show you what I found. And this is unbelievable. Loads of it. This was that was all in a skip. Well, it was going to go in a skip. Someone was getting a new conservatory or something, and that was the old conservatory offcut bits. So, it's like I say, keep your eyes open, keep them peeled, and you'll find stuff like that. So today, I've got enough there. I'm going to fix all the broken glass in the greenhouse with it. In fact, there's a load of broken glass here, I've just noticed. And I'm going to fix that window in the shed, make it a bit warmer. So I'll crack on with that. But I was just listening to the gardening programme there, and it says that today is the bird watch, the National Bird Watch Survey. Well, there's not many birds out today, but they were saying, cooking fat, it's not good for birds, so don't use it. I'll stand here because it's raining. Don't use it, it's not good for the birds. Apparently it doesn't do any good for the fellas, and it knocks them up, basically. That brings us on to another thing. I don't actually feed. I've got a bird table there. I've never put stuff on it for years, because if you do start feeding the birds in your garden, you have to make sure that you're there every day, because the birds, they'll get used to it, and then if you don't put anything out, the birds will not know where to go for food, and they'll starve, they'll not survive. So it's all good if you do, every day, if you put the food out for them, it's good. It's like I say, it's feed the birds and all that. But if you only put seed out every now and again, I wouldn't do it. It's not doing the birds any good. You've got to look after the little birds, because they'll look after you in the summer. So, I'm going to get the saw out, get measuring, put new windows in, see how it goes before it gets too dark. So I'll see you in a bit. Well, would you believe it? The sun's out for now, like, stopped raining. So I'll be able to crack on with this, get it all done before it gets too dark. Let's go.
day's flight is Paula Thompson. Hi there, Paula. He said, Kathy, will you please tell Paula that I miss her? And I can't wait to see her again next Saturday. And this song is It Must Be Love. Here of Madness.
Just for you, Paula. Well, all the little bits I need are cut, so I'm going to start here, put them along, and while I took the glass out, I've been chopping back some of this grapevine, because I don't want them growing out the windows again. Some of the clips were stuck earlier on, I couldn't get them out. So like I say, to get this piece in, you have to take this piece out and this piece. So I work along, give it a bit of all the glass a bit clean as well, because you want to try and keep it as clean as you can. So I'll get on with that. Like I say, all the bits are cut, so not long before I'll have a draft-free greenhouse again. But like I say though, this plastic, it's just amazing what people don't need, you know? And just if you look about, you find things. I mean, I'm a window cleaner, so I get to see a lot of things when people are doing building work and that, you know, and I just ask the people if I can have it. But like I say, it was all going to go in a skip. It's amazing how dirty the glass gets like. I'll clip back some of this as well. A couple of years ago, I can't remember if I showed you, there's a grapevine down there. If you wanted to take cuttings, it's quite easy. Just for example, that there, what I did, cut it off, take to the nearest bud, on like an angle, you know, take off all these bits. Have about, I don't know, 10 inches, then cut it off. And then what I did, it's just I stuck that in the ground, and it took 2 years to root and start to grow. So it can be done, easy to take grape cuttings, but like I say, you've got to have them somewhere where you can leave them for a couple of years. Anyway, I'll get on with what I was doing. What I've done is cut them slightly, couple of mil, bit more than what you need. Then you can push it in, and it's. I mean, I'll still put some clips on, but it'll be all right. There's one. Branches need coming off there. Right, I see it doesn't do any harm to the actual thing, and I've got to prune it back. This has been in here for 4 years now, and as you can see, it's getting a canny thick vein on it. Like, get the cloth. It's amazing how the moss and the dirt builds up, like. Spot on. I just put the bit of glass back after I've given it a wipe round. Late nights are starting to come back now. And I've noticed as well, the flowers are all starting to come out. So, spring is on its way. Well, that'll do for that. It's the other side to do, and then that's it. And then it's tidy time. So, catch yous in a bit. Well, just before it gets too dark, I'll show you around. That's what I've been. I've got loads of this stuff left. There's four sheets there. And I've filled in all the gaps. There's a couple of pieces up here that the glass has just slid down, so I need to get out there, but thing is, when I put this greenhouse up, I didn't think ahead. And there isn't any. There's about half a foot gap in between the fence and the shed, and I can't bloody get into it. So I'll have to figure out some way of doing that another time, because it's getting too dark now. The rain's been off and on all day. I've been using that to keep my camera dry. But like I say, it's just starting to get dark there now. I've still got two massive sheets of this stuff left. And that's that plastic that I already had up. But two big sheets of it there still, plus these. So I'm going to have a think. Put me thinking cap on, see what I can come up with, make something. There's a couple of bits of glass that needs fixing in this greenhouse actually, so that'll do okay for that. I haven't done anything. This artichoke here, now this is weird. Well, not weird, but it's the first time it's done this. Remember I planted that? It was quite late on in the summer. I didn't get any artichokes off it. But within the past month or so, it's just doubled in size. I never used to get them that big, so see what they turn up like. Well, that's about it, folks. I'll make a cuppa, have a sit down in the fire for a bit and have a chill out for 5 minutes. Well, it's getting a bit dark now. Time to start wrapping things up. I'm not going to start wrapping, like, unless you want us to. There. Annie's over there on the chair, like usual. What was I saying? I am glad I've got everything done. The weather's brightened up. It's February next week, so things have to be starting soon. We'll be planting seeds and what have you within no time. Now, you might have watched my videos. I know a few of you have because you've commented in there. Thanks for all the comments, by the way. I only put that Michael Jackson clip up because I thought it was funny when the cat whacked us. I didn't know what the hell was going on, you know. Whoa. But thanks for all the comments and that. Glad it made some people laugh. Obviously, it didn't make 5 people laugh. But I'm not bothered about dislikes. I'm not going to start rambling on about that. Like I say, I've been making some videos up in Throckley when I've been staying at Paula's, and there's some really interesting places up there. So if you're interested in them videos, I'll be putting